Well, I wonder if you feel any more hopeful. I know the last few weeks and months have been different for all of us, but now that restrictions are beginning to lift, and now that new drugs and medication is being developed, and now that there's even chat of barbers opening in the not too distant future, I wonder if you feel any more hopeful. Hope. It's something that all of us long for, and the Bible is absolutely explicit in speaking about hope. And in Proverbs 10:28, the proverb speaks about hope, and here's what it says. It says, "The hope of the righteous brings joy." Now, this isn't just any kind of hope from any kind of person. This is the hope of a righteous person, which really means someone who is perfect before God. And for that person, they have true hope. A sure and certain and everlasting hope, which ultimately brings joy. Not just happiness, not some short-term emotional reaction, but a joy. A deep and sure contentment and satisfaction and delight in God, because for the righteous person, they receive God. It gives a joy that's ultimately fulfilled in the life to come. That's the righteous person, but the proverb also speaks of a person who's not righteous, and they're described as a wicked person. And for that person, the proverb says there is no hope. Instead, they have expectation, something that looks hopeful, something that seems to give a sense of hope, but in the end, it's not safe, it's not secure. And along with their lives, it eventually fades away. For unless a person is righteous, there is no true hope that brings true joy, ultimately fulfilled in the life to come. When you read through this proverb, it's kind of designed to make you want to be like the first person, the righteous person. The problem is that none of us are righteous. Except for one. Because the Bible speaks of Jesus. And when Jesus came and lived amongst us, he was perfect before God. For the Bible says that he followed and upheld every part of the law. And before God, he was declared righteous. And for all of those who turn to him, and when we put our faith and trust in Jesus, by his death, he removes all of our wickedness. And he declares us and makes us righteous so that in him we can have a true, a permanent, a safe and secure hope that it brings a joy ultimately fulfilled in the life to come when we receive and meet him. Maybe this week, as you look at restrictions being lifted and you see all the changes that are taking place or beginning to take place, you feel a sense of hope. But it's not true hope. It's not a safe or secure or everlasting hope. But for those of us who turn to Jesus and put our faith and trust in Jesus, there is righteousness that brings a true, a safe and secure and everlasting hope that leads to joy, ultimately fulfilled in the life to come.